Hey, Phil, Paul Michael here. Today is December 23rd, right? What time is it? It's 5:45 p.m. People see that star right there? I thought it was an airplane. People are sitting like half an hour ago, right? It's not Jupiter, but look how close it is, people. I thought it was an airplane. It's huge. Now it's smaller, guys. It's far away from me now. People, look at that. That star setting in the west. I mean in the northwest. I thought I seen it earlier, I thought it was a plane, but it's still there, so it couldn't be a plane. Can I hear Jupiter up here? There's Jupiter up here, right? Is that Venus? This Jupiter right here. So what star is that? I thought it was a plane. I see people, it was so close earlier, I should have gotten it. I'm gonna get it tomorrow. Wow, that's a new star, people. Maybe it's Venus, but I haven't seen it. I've never seen the star right there before. Okay, this is in the northwest. Over here we have two stars together. But look how close to the ground it is, people. Look how close. It is so long. And it's huge. So tomorrow I'm gonna be looking out for it. Came out like about 5 o'clock maybe, half an hour ago. I came out here and I saw it. I thought it was a plane. It was so close to the ground and so huge. What star is that though? Only Venus. Is that Venus? I gotta check it out. Oh, I missed it. People, it was so closer to me, right? It was huge. I'm like, wow, what a plane doing so close. I came out half an hour later and it's still there. So I'm definitely gonna be checking for him tomorrow. Hey. Alright, what's going on? Yeah. All right. So people, I'm gonna be looking out for him tomorrow when it's above the trees. When it's close, I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna get him tomorrow. All right. Gonna go down lower, so why not? Hey people, I'm gonna use this opportunity, right, to tell y'all what I've been figuring out, right? People, right, this figure here that you're seeing, right, is a statue of it's a Greek statue, a Roman statue, right? It is supposed to be a statue of the morning star and the evening star. It also represents the sun and the moon, night and day, the ability to see in the future and in the past, the ability to see danger before it comes, okay? So which to me is the face of God, the all-seeing, eyes of God. You can see in the future and in the past, okay? In the front and in the back. Now people, as you can see, one face is light and one face is dark. This is also means God and the devil. People, the devil is not evil. The devil just means the dead. Okay, or the deceased. Okay, lived. Turn devil around and you spell lived. Okay, so the devil is supposed to be Osiris because he once lived and now he's dead. So he lived. And the Egyptians used to write and spell from left to right. Sorry people, quick correction here. The Egyptians did not read or write from the left to the right. They actually read and write from the right to the left. So it was the Romans, the shepherd kings, who came and changed things around. The Romans who changed things around and had to start reading and writing from the left to the right. But the Egyptian did it from the right to the left. That's why they're so confused. That's why they don't know what pyramid text means, because they're reading it wrong. Okay, that's why. So when the Romans, when not the Romans really, the Rothschild, when the Rothschild came and conquered Egypt, the shepherd kings came and conquered Egypt, what they did was they changed, they started reading the language, the pyramid text from right to left and confuse everything. Okay, so in the translation, they did the same thing. So they're not such thing as devil, and they're not such thing as God. Devil means lived, and God is dog. Okay, that's all it is. So don't let people trick you. So anyway, what I'm trying to say, people, is that this statue here signify what I said. And the proof is, people, and the Egyptian pharaoh head, right? What's on the Egyptian pharaoh head? He have a serpent and a phoenix. Okay, the bird and the snake. Now, people, if you put a bird and a snake together, what will happen? The serpent will eat the bird. Will eat it. They are mortal enemies. Just like you say, God and the devil. Okay? God and the devil. So, the man was created for one purpose, right? Man was created to unite who? God and the devil as one, because people, without God and the devil, there's no existence. It's a counterbalance. The devil is a counterbalance in an ordinary universe. Okay? God needs the devil needs God, because they counter each other. Without one, the other one gonna collapse. So anyway, the proof is, people, okay, people, look at a light bulb, right? In a wire, you have a positive wire and a negative wire. Black wire, white wire, positive, negative, right? Now, if you look at a light switch, when you turn the light switch on, right, you have two separate wires, right? The wire goes where? Up to the light bulb, right? And when they reach the tip of the light bulb, what we get? We get light. Two dangerous sources uniting one to create light, harmony. Now, if in between those wires, if you cut those wires and you touch them, what you get a short circuit, right? You get a short circuit. So the only place God and the devil can meet is where? At a place of unity in man. Okay, so now I forget to tell people's spirit, the body of man was created to contain God and the devil, to contain them in harmony, because God and the devil is always at odds with each other, because they counter each other, and that's how it's supposed to be. And but they wanted peace, they wanted to unite, because they realized, listen man, we work together, so we work in harmony together, but we can't touch each other. If we touch each other, it's going to be short circuit. It's going to be flames and sparks and destruction. But we need each other. So how are we going to overcome that? Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. And in them, in those men, we will unite. In man, we will unite as one. And through man, we'll be able to control the storms, control the evil, the violence. True man will be able to control that. So the body was created, people, to what? To imprison the soul of God and the devil. The body was created to imprison that. But man had been tricked into allowing the serpent and the bird, which is God and the devil, to imprison him. Okay, they control us. They die. They could kill us anytime they want to kill us. We have no silver, but yet they created us to contain them. So now, instead of the body being the prison for the soul, instead of the soul, how you put it? Instead of the body being made to contain the soul, the soul is now controlling the body. And that's why people die and get sick, because the devil or the evil aspect of us causes to use drugs that destructive, you know, destructive stuff. Anyway, the point I'm trying to make, people, the proof, right, is in the Egyptian Pharaoh head. Okay, on his head he have the serpent and the rainbow. In his hand he have the rod and the staff, God and the devil. And in man, they're supposed to unite. In man. Okay. It's also the serpent is also the moon. And the phoenix is the sun. Okay, the sun and the moon together. That's how man came to the sun and the moon. Okay. That's how we was created, by the powers of the sun and the moon. How they did it, I don't know. That will come later on, but the proof right here is in the Pharaoh's head. And these other pictures, people, I didn't fake these pictures. One day I was just messing around with the camera. I had the camera in front of my face, holding the camera and just letting it roll. And when I went downstairs and put it in my computer, I seen the sun in my head and this thing in my eye. I swear to you, I didn't even know it was there, people. I did not know it was there when I was taking the film. I did not know. If I knew it was there, I probably wouldn't have came out like that. I was just fooling around. I said, let me see what's gonna happen if I put this camera in my face. And I turned towards the sun, I turned my back to the sun, and I put a camera in my face, and that's what you see. I didn't fake anything. So anyway, these pictures, they're significant. Take it for what it means. I'm not trying to prove anything. I'm just trying to show you all how it is, okay? So take it how you all want to take it. But there's strange things going on, people. Okay? Like I said again, the serpent and the rainbow signify God and the devil. And it means that in them, in man, they are supposed to be united in one. As one. One love.